Good evening. I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. I am constantly asked why it is that I concentrate on children's books aimed at the very young. And the answer, of course, is they are short and they can be encompassed in a video. Not so books for teens. In this particular case, I have a very weak spot indeed, because I happen to have a great interest in books for teens. And the reason is that I have a daughter of my own who's about to celebrate her 21st birthday, and the Hoare House prides itself on sharing its literature. In this case, daughter Bryony, who is named after a celebrated Welsh plant called Bryonia, B-R-Y-O-N-I-A, came up with this book on her own behest called The Hazel Wood by one Melissa Albers. I'd never heard of the lady. I'd seen her reviewed, but I'd never handled her. She read the book and absolutely loved it, recommended it to her mum, who soaked it up like a sponge in turn, and finally the two of them prevailed on me, with very little difficulty, to do the same myself. All three of us have read, enjoyed, and appreciated this extraordinary book, which is a mixture of realism, if you will, and fantasy. It is set partially in New York, New York City, and partially in a horribly scary place called the hinterland. Dark trees, ghostly wafts, the whole atmospheric. The book is extraordinary. It concerns Alice, a 17-year-old, who becomes enamored, at least she thinks so, with a young man called Finch. It's the story of how the boy slowly but surely sucks the girl into the vortex of her past, and more specifically her granny's past. And her grandmother had written years earlier a very famous book indeed, on which she traded for the rest of her life. And the boy, who has roots set in that story, comes to life within the confines of the hinterland. Grimm's fairy tales were not written for children. They were written for older people, borderline teens, full teens, grown-ups. And it was only the grown-ups who really ended up appreciating the nuance in that book, in those stories. So too in The Hazelwood. It's ostensibly aimed at teens, but it isn't. It's aimed at all of us. It's a wonderful story, and I believe, on excellent authority, that the sequel is coming out in 2019. And frankly, the Hoare House can't wait. And on that suspenseful note, good night.